We have taken the first step on our way to immortality. You now know that you have a soul. How do we continue? Which are the next steps?
Some try to gain immortality by extending the life of the body. However, this is impossible. Everything material is bound to pass away.
The immortality of your body is not even desirable. The life of your soul in its homeland, the world beyond, after the death of the body, is indispensable to your spiritual development.
If you want to become immortal, you have to transform into a non-material, spiritual being that is not limited by the restrictions of matter, space, and time, and therefore cannot die. We have learned in the first step, we humans consist of two parts. We are twofold, like the Roman god, Janus. Two souls are dwelling in my breast. Our being is composed of a material, visible, mortal body and a spiritual, invisible, immortal soul.
If this is so, then you have the choice. Who or what do you want to be? Whom of these two parts do you want to regard as your true self? Of whom of the two would you like to say, "This is me," of the body or of the soul? Of course, you will choose the soul.
No one will regard the perishable part of his nature as his true ego after recognizing that there is an eternal being as well. You will not choose to be something that will soon cease to exist when you can be something else that is everlasting.
Of course, you would rather be an immortal than a transient being.
The second step towards immortality is you assume a new identity.
Up to today, you have saddled the wrong horse. The old man identifies with his body. This is hardly reasonable. The new man identifies with his soul, which he regards as his true self. For that, what is eternal, is certainly more real and more important than that what is perishable.
The personal man is ephemeral, incidental to the real man or soul, who is an evolving, persisting entity, eternal in the heavens, who never had a beginning and to whose life there can be no end. With the growth of the idea of the soul as being the important part comes the perception of the unity of all life. Change your identity.
As long as your body is your ego, your existence ends with its death. When the soul becomes your ego, you continue to live on eternally, even after the death of the body. When you are asked, "Who are you?" Answer:
I am a soul. I am not a material. I am a spiritual being. Previously, you used to think, "I have a soul." Correct, however, is, "I am a soul."
Do you see? You have already turned into an immortal being. For once you are a soul, you go on living after the death of the body.
We have to form a completely new picture of ourselves. Man is a species belonging to the spiritual world that can neither be seen nor touched. Antiquity from the two premises, "All humans are mortal," and "I am a human being," drew the conclusion, "I am mortal." Today, we establish two new premises: "All souls are immortal," and "I am a soul," from which we conclude, "I am immortal." We immortals beseech you, see through the illusion of matter. The sun does not go down in the sea in the evening. It only appears to do so. At the age of 75 years, one cannot fail to think about death from time to time. This thought leaves me in complete peace, for I have the firm conviction that our spirit is a being of an indestructible nature. Its activity is continuing from eternity to eternity. It is like the sun, which seems to go down only to our earthly eyes, but which in reality never sets, but shines on unceasingly.
You must overcome the illusion of matter in relation to yourself as well. You are not the body that acts on earth. You are the spirit that animates that body. You are not the dress, which is constantly changing. You are the everlasting creature which bears the dress.
You are not the person which you perceive in the mirror, the figure with head, torso, and limbs. This is only illusion, short-lived cover.
Previously, you used to believe that you are a body. To be sure, you also had a soul, but you did not really know what to make of it, and certainly not of its eternal life. Today, you have to change your picture of yourself and say, "I am a soul. I also have a body," which, however, does not matter very much because it will soon perish.
So, to know the real, do not think you have a soul, but the soul has you.
You are that what remains after your body has died.
Remember the near-death experiences which we have already talked about. You are not the body which lies on the operating table. You are the invisible spiritual being who is watching from the ceiling. All human beings are actually immortal. They just do not know. Do not allow yourself to be deceived like a mayfly, which ridicules the term month. Rise up. You are much greater than you think. You are a cosmic giant who already lived before our Earth existed, and who will continue to live when this insignificant chunk of matter has long disintegrated. My body is a tool which I, the soul, have to use because I, as a non-material spiritual being, cannot appear and act on the physical plane without such a vehicle. Just as a deep sea diver is able to descend to the bottom of the sea only in a solid diving bell.
See through the illusion of matter. In this case, too, the true ego is not the outwardly visible shell, the diving bell, but the invisible being hidden within the shell, the diver.
The monks regard the body as their little friend and companion and call it Brother Donkey. Thereby they express very nicely its serving function. You, however, are not the donkey. You are the rider. The body decays after death and is gnawed by worms. The resurrection of this cadaver, worn out and grown unappealing by long use, is a fairy tale incompatible with the laws of reason and of science.
Moreover, no one can seriously desire the immortality of his frail and, with increasing age, ever more defective body.
The body is like a marionette which has to play a role. It is led to and fro on the stage of earthly life by the will of an invisible player. You are the player, not the doll. How should we treat our physical being? Of course, you should keep your body fit through a little training and preserve it as a suitable tool. More attention is not required for an object which will soon disintegrate.
Is it not ridiculous for a man to care for and to decorate his donkey rather than to embellish himself? It is much more important that you nurture, heal, train, and make great and strong your true imperishable self, your soul. When you learn to think and to act in this way, then your transformation into an immortal being begins. Let us summarize this second. Let us summarize. The second step on the way to immortality is but small and easy to accomplish. It takes place solely within our minds. You change your identity and say confidently,
I am not a physical being. I am not a body. I am a spiritual being. I am a soul. You achieve immortality by learning to become a soul.